Hello guys. Welcome back to the another video of AIMAIME. In this video we will learn about centrifugal casting, its working principle, types, application, and advantages and disadvantages. But before going to our today's topic, I request you to consider subscribing. Also press the bell icon so you won't miss any of my latest updates. Centrifugal casting is one of the most important type of casting process, in which mold is rotated rapidly about its central axis, during casting is solidified or metal is poured. This process is widely used for casting hollow pipes, tubes, and other symmetrical parts. So let's check out the working principle of the centrifugal casting. Centrifugal casting works on basic principle of centrifugal force on a rotating component. In this process, a mold is rotated about its central axis when the molten metal is poured into it. A centrifugal force acts on molten metal due to this rotation, which forces the metal at outer wall of mold. The mold rotates until the whole casting solidifies. The slag oxide and other inclusion being lighter, gets separated from metal and segregate towards the center. There are three types of centrifugal casting. That is true centrifugal casting, semi-centrifugal casting and centrifuging. Let's check out all process, one by one. True centrifugal casting is sometimes known as centrifugal casting. It is a process of making symmetrical round hollow sections. This process uses no cores and the symmetrical hollow section is created by pure centrifugal action. In this process, the mold rotates about horizontal or vertical axis. Mostly the mold is rotated about horizontal axis and the molten metal introduced from an external source. The centrifugal force acts on the molten metal which forces it at the outer wall of mold. The mold rotates until the whole casting solidifies. The slag particles are lighter than metal, thus separated at the central part of the casting and removed by machining or other suitable process. This process used to make hollow pipes, tubes, hollow bushes etc. which are axisymmetrical with a concentric hole. Next one is semi-centrifugal casting process. This process is used to cast large size axisymmetrical object. In this process mold is placed horizontally and rotated along the vertical axis. A core is inserted at the center which is used to cast hollow section. When the mold rotates, the outer portion of the mold fill by purely centrifugal action, and as the liquid metal approaches toward the center, the centrifugal component decreases and gravity component increase. Thus a core is inserted at center to make hollow cavity at the center without centrifugal force. In this process centrifugal force is used for uniform filling of axisymmetrical parts. Gear blanks, flywheel etc. are made by this process. Last one is centrifuging. In this process there are several mold cavities connected with a central spro with radial gates. This process uses higher metal pressure during solidification. It is used to cast shapes which are not axisymmetrical. This is only suitable for small objects. Let's check out the application of centrifugal casting. It is widely used in aircraft industries to cast rings, flanges and compressor casting. It is used for cast steam turbine bearing shell. Roller for steel rolling mill is another example of centrifugal casting. It is used in automobile industries to cast gear blank, cylindrical liners, piston rings etc. It is used to cast bearings. This process used to cast switchgear components used in electronic industries. Let's check out the advantages of centrifugal casting. It provides dense metal and high mechanical properties. Unidirectional solidification can obtain up to a certain thickness. It can use for mass production. No cores are required for cast hollow shapes like tubes etc. Gating system and runner are totally eliminated. All the impurity like oxide or other slag particles, segregated at center from where it can easily remove. It required lower pouring temperature, thus save energy. Lower casting defects due to uniform solidification. Moving ahead are the disadvantages. Limited design can be cast boulette in this process. It can cast only symmetrical shapes. High equipment or setup cost is required in this process. It is not suitable for every metal. Higher maintenance required. High skill operator required. In this casting process, solidification time and temperature distribution is difficult to determine. So guys, that was all about centrifugal casting, its working principle, types, application, advantages, and disadvantages. If you have any doubts regarding this video, ask us by commenting. If you like this video, don't forget to share it on social networks. Subscribe our educational channel AmAmy for more informative videos. In the next video we will learn the process of injection molding. Till then, stay tuned with AmAmy.